Hi students, today we learn about the one of the important question of microeconomics and macroeconomics differences. In a modern economic theory was divided into two parts, namely one microeconomics, in second one macroeconomics. The first used the words micro and macroeconomics. In these two terms, economics theory in 1993 in Ragnar Frisch of in Oslo University of Norway. In first one, macroeconomics. Microeconomics. The term microeconomics is derived from the Greek word micros, which means small. Microeconomics studies about the individual parts of the theory. For example, individual consumers, in firms, industry, income, savings, price, etc. Microeconomics was developed by Alfred Marshall. It is also known as price theory. In next one, macroeconomics. Macroeconomics is derived from the Greek word makros, which means big or large. Macroeconomics studies about the economic system as a whole. For example, total product, income, investment, savings, aggregate demand and supply, etc. The macroeconomics studies the national income, not individual income, general price level instead of individual prices, and national output instead of individual output. In next one, microeconomics and macroeconomics in differences. In microeconomics, the microeconomics, it is derived from the micro, from the in Greek word micros, means small. In next one, the word macros derived from the Greek word makros, means large. Microeconomic is the study of individual units of the economy. Macroeconomics is the study of economy as a whole, in total. In next one, microeconomics was developed by Alfred Marshall. In next one, it was developed by J.M. Keynes. It is known as a price theory. It is known as a income and employment theory. Microeconomics explains price determination in both commodity and factor markets. Macroeconomics deals with the national income, total employment, aggregate savings and investments. Microeconomics is based on price mechanism, which depends on demand and supply. Macroeconomics is based on aggregate demand and aggregate supply. The next one, it is based on partial equilibrium analysis. It is based on general equilibrium analysis. Next one, it is a static analysis with out time element. It is a dynamic analysis with time element. It is the difference between the microeconomics and macroeconomics. Thanks for watching.